Hey, my name is Dr. Jamin Brombot, and I am a urologist and sexual health expert with Orlando Health. And today, we're going to be discussing intimate taboo topics, which I hope will no longer be taboo in your mind after you've listened to what we have to say today. Today's taboo topic is erectile dysfunction. Erectile dysfunction affects over 40% of men over the age of 40 and over 70% of men over the age of 70. So it's nothing that you should feel is taboo, nothing that you should feel you can't talk to me about or any of your other doctors about, because it's very common. Erectile dysfunction is essentially where you are no longer able to get an erection or sustain an erection. So how do you get erections? You get erections essentially when a gush of blood goes into your penis and stays there. So there has to be a almost synchronous interaction between your nerves and your blood vessels. So if you can imagine, anything that can affect your overall nerves, such as diabetes, strokes, certain medications, or anything that can affect your blood vessels, such as, again, diabetes, or add on to their things like blood pressure, or even side effects of medications, all these things can affect your ability to have that perfect erection. The first misconception around erectile dysfunction is that it's a testosterone issue. Testosterone is essentially a hormone that regulates many things in your body, but when it comes to your sexual health, it regulates your libido, so your sexual drive. So all because you have a low testosterone, it doesn't mean this is the cause of your erectile dysfunction. So there may be guys that can have erections or have issues with sex, but there may be another reality is their partner, and the partner may have vaginal dryness because they're postmenopausal, so sexual activity may cause pain. Their partner may also have some issues with libido and sexual drive, or as a couple, they may have relationship issues. So I personally, when I'm seeing these patients in the office, like I would prefer that the partner is there with them. A third misconception is erectile dysfunction is that treatments are way expensive. And yes, back in the day, things like Viagra and Cialis were extremely expensive, but now these medications are actually generic. You can get them for sometimes under $1 a pill, which is a huge game changer for us because we can now much more freely prescribe this medication and it's much more accessible to you as a patient. If the pills don't work, that's not the end of the road for you. Like, it's not like you have to give up on sex. There's so many other things that we can offer you, and these things may include, yes, you have the medications that help you get erections, but then you have vacuum erection devices. You may have seen this in the Austin Powers movies, but this actually does exist. Another thing is something called penile injection therapy. And that is where there's certain medications that we can compound, and using a small little needle, very tiny little needle, most of my patients can't even feel it, we would teach you how to inject your penis into the bodies that actually get hard when you're getting erections. And that's something called penile injection therapy. And finally, there's actually some great surgical options when it comes to prosthetics for erectile dysfunction. And that is when we can actually put a penile implant inside of you. So a penile implant, I know it sounds crazy, but we put a ton of these in here and patients do great. It's a game changer for patients because you don't have to think about injections. You don't have to think about a pump. You don't have to think about, oh, is this medication gonna work? Essentially, you get a device put inside of you. So these two are inside your penis. This is a pump inside your scrotum, and this is a reservoir that goes inside your belly. No one even knows you have it. And when you're ready to go, all you have to do is pump, 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 pump. And then when you're done, you basically deflate the mechanism. So all these treatment options are safe when you undertake them under the care of an experienced professional. It can be someone like us that are urologists that specialize in sexual health. It could be a general urologist as well that has an interest in sexual health, or it could even be your primary care physician. As long as it's with someone that does it all the time and explains to you the risks and the benefits in detail, then I think it is fairly safe. I think the biggest mistake men make is they go out and seek treatments on their own. If you just type in erectile dysfunction, there's hundreds of supplements with really weird and interesting names out there that you can buy. Let me tell you something. A majority of these supplements do not work. So don't waste your time, don't waste your money, and a lot of it, or most of it, is not FDA regulated. Another issue men get into is they spend a lot of money for these treatments thinking they have to go to these ultra specialized clinics that offer you the world. All you're, that's going to happen to you in those clinics is you're going to be dropping about $5,000 or $6,000 on things that you could just get done with a licensed medical professional like us. And most of what we do is covered by your insurance. Here at Orlando Health, we have not just me, but we have a lot of urologists. And so help can only be a drive away or even a walk away.